Welcome, friends. Myself, Dr. Sonal Desai. I am Energy and Sustainability Engineer, and I am here to discuss about energy modeling courses. This energy modeling course is made of 7-module course, and in this 7-module course, it is discussed how to perform energy modeling. Here, OpenStudio platform is used, which is GUI of EnergyPlus energy simulation tool, and using that in a step-by-step procedure, how energy modeling is done, that is discussed. This is introduction of the entire course. Here, prior starting to that, one should know that what is energy modeling and why one should go for energy modeling. Also, what answers a model can give prior making it and who gets benefit from doing energy modeling. There is also mention about methodology to perform energy modeling as well as what data is required to perform this energy modeling. And lastly, there are mention about different tools. They are used generally for doing energy modeling. So friends, energy modeling is a process of computer analysis, which can anticipate the performance of building prior making to it. So at the design stage, there can be certain decisions carried out, certain key analysis can be done, which helps the end user to anticipate the changes that can be accommodated in the building for optimum performance of the building. So normally residential and commercial buildings consume world around 40% of total energy. So it is a need of time that prior making a building, a modeling has to be done. It also helps to evaluate different design decisions in terms of life cycle cost analysis. When multiple options are there, then selecting a particular option from its life cycle cost analysis, it can be done with the use of energy modeling software. As just said, optimization of building energy performance by selecting and designing several internal and external factors, it can be done using energy modeling. It involves many parameters like HVAC design, thermal zoning, occupancy, scheduling, load, and so on. So this parameter can be optimized at design stage. Also for LEED certification as well as to meet compliances of building standards, energy modeling is a must process. So what answers model can provide? It can provide basically three types of answers as mentioned in this slide. It will give architectural answers, it will give HVAC related answers, also it can give whole building simulations. So what a facade will look like, what are the features, what building construction is done, what type of HVAC system is there, and its energy analysis. These answers are available when we perform energy modeling process. Who gets benefit from energy? Apart from the main benefit to the environment, also the beneficiary of this process are engineers, those who are working in the field of energy, energy consultants, building facilitators, manufacturers, building owners, civil engineers, architects, and sustainability engineers, they all will be benefited when they go for energy modeling process. So what exactly a process of energy modeling that is shown over here? It is basically made of three steps. First step is about gathering the data. This data accumulation is a very exhaustive process and it involves lot many informations. It starts with drawing of actually built building, utility bills of electricity as well as gas, then equipment schedule, when and in which pattern they are going to operate, lighting drawings and lighting density details, the square footage information of each and every part of the building, what is occupancy of the building, type of occupancy, nature of use, also schedule of occupancy and building functions as well as purpose that is required. So once all this data is available, a model can be done. Once making the model, second stage is to run the model, that is perform the simulation. So it will generate output files and these output files are user-friendly files wherein multiple forms data are available. So this data can be used to understand what is the output of energy modeling. And lastly, the most important part is using energy saving measures. This Energy modeling is basically done to reduce energy consumption. So we may apply different types of energy measures. Some are designed and available, or some we may plan and we may design. So this energy saving measure will propose the change or the reduction in energy consumption pattern of the building. So a user can have anticipated value of energy saving. So what do I need before going for energy modeling? As just mentioned in step one, that we need to collect different data. So this are again summarized over here, that one should know what is the location of the building, because once knowing the location, weather data file and other detailed files can be imported to the model. Then a geometry, that is a building shape, construction, the features, the floor plans, everything is required. Then there is a requirement of knowledge about building material, that is, building is made of which material, what composites materials, what layers are used, wall, windows, doors, skylights, all which type of material they are made of, that requirement is there. And then general operation of the building, that is, what is occupancy time of the building, what are the equipment loads during day or night time, that type of sequencing is required. All internal loads, that is plug loads, they are required. It will include all types of load, all electrical as well as occupants activity has to be included. And then there has to be information available about thermal zoning, that is which part of the building will be operating in the same temperature zones. That information is required. And lastly, what is detailing of HVAC system, that is type of HVAC system, their operating parameters, their efficiencies, whether it is a chilled water type or direct expansion type, and many more details. So all these details, when available, energy modeling can be started. There are multiple energy modeling tools, because energy modeling started since last 40-50 years. So a lot many advancements is there, a lot many development is there, and many tools are available for performing energy modeling. So if I just mention few name of them, then worldwide famous softwares are eQuest and EnergyPlus to model the building. eQuest and CanQuest are almost same. The one designed by DOE for Canada, that is CanQuest. Then there is a carrier HAP, which is used for HVAC design and load calculation. TRES 700, again a software. IES V5 is again used in UK-based countries, design builder. And OpenStudio, they are also modeling softwares. So software can be any. Ultimate goal is to simulate performance of the building. So here there are some slides mentioning different energy performing tools, and their user interface as well as their output files are shown over here. This is about BEopt simulation tool, which is normally used for residential type of applications. So whole house energy simulation can be carried out in this type of software, and it will give us simulation based analysis for different parameters, like about architectural features, its size, its location, its utility rates, its envelope, and all. So that can be opted for BEopt software, and it is normally recommended for residential type of building. So this first image is about its building making user interface to create a building drawing, and the second one is showing its output file. So this another model, which is modeling software, which is worldwide known, that is eQuest, and we do have its module series from 8 module, and that discusses energy modeling using eQuest in detail. So friends, if you are interested to go for eQuest software, then go for energy modeling by eQuest. There 1 to 8 modules, they have a detailed designing as well as hand-on practice of using eQuest software. Just like this OpenStudio series, there is another series called eQuest energy modeling software. Link is also provided over here for that. eQuest is a very quick and easy to learn simulation software. Of course, they have certain limitations, but again, it's very easy to use software, and we can design many parameters like construction, building envelope, orientation, HVAC, good amount of energy saving measures are also there, and we can perform energy modeling. So here again, it's building geometry making as well as output files are shown. For a standard size and shape of the building, we can directly use that interface or we can import CAD file in the eQuest software. OpenStudio, that is the present one we are talking of, that is again a cross-platform, and it is, we can say that OpenStudio is a front end of the EnergyPlus, which is a main energy simulation engine. And EnergyPlus is not a user interface, it is intended to be a simulation engine around which a third party interface can be wrapped up. So OpenStudio is one of such interfaces. Then there is a RETScreen software, which is more popular for renewable sources. One person who is working in the field of wind, solar, geothermal, to them RETScreen is a useful software. As just mentioned, this is a 7-module course. Each module has a different compositions, and it will talk from starting with the building envelope design to defining energy use and spaces to HVAC, and then advanced HVAC, that is looping of HVAC. And then in further modules, there will be applying measures to see the energy saving effects, parametric analysis in PAT, and lastly, there is daylighting control in the last module. So when you go through all 7 modules, your knowledge for energy modeling using OpenStudio and EnergyPlus will be enhanced. And who should take up this course? Those who are working in the field of building, engineers, auditors, consultants, facility managers, building managers, energy consultants, lead professionals, and architects. They will have benefit of going through this course. This was introduction course. For detail, you need to go for registration in all 7 modules. Thanks for watching this introduction video. We'll see you at the detail course. Thank you.